What's cracking, folks? Back with another reaction, back with some more Depeche Mode, and we're back with a tune from an album I just got, even though it did come out in 2017. This is the album Spirit. We're going to listen to maybe the most famous tune, certainly my favorite tune from the album, Where's the Revolution? Shout out to this awesome photo on the back. R.I.P. Andy Fletcher, we see there. I did want to mention, like I said, I just got this album, so I had to throw it up here, but yeah, it spells out, you know, Depeche Mode on the liner notes. As I mentioned, this is from 2017. The tune we're going to listen to, Where's the Revolution? Show the disc here if I can get it out properly. It is a tune which has a more political bent, certainly. It's interesting, though, because, you know, in a way, the lyrics fit with a lot of the lyrics of punk bands I listen to, like Subhumans and Bad Religion and Dead Kennedys and so on, but also other bands like Iron Maiden who have touched on some political concepts in their songs, and, you know, System of a Down and, you know, Bad Brains and so on. There's a lot of bands I listen to who make the general points here that ordinary people are often subject to the violent, destructive, or at least unnecessary and excessive whims of the systems in which they find themselves, whether political systems or religious systems or cultural systems, so that, you know, political leaders and religious authorities and, you know, nationalistic societies and cultures that sort of push people in different directions and make them part of larger processes that are ultimately harmful and which cause, you know, destruction and strife and chaos. And so the song is basically saying, you know, you're pushed down, your rights are taken away, you're lied to, you're made to, you know, be parts of these larger things that you may not approve of. Ultimately, you know, in light of all these external pressures and maybe internal as well, where's the revolution? You know, shouldn't it be time for the citizens to basically say we're tired of having, you know, governments and religions and you know, cultural institutions decide our fates for us and make us do things which ultimately put us into conflict with other ordinary people who want little more than just to kind of get by and, you know, live their life with a modicum of fulfillment. But it's interesting because despite that being where I took this song when I first heard it and where I think it's a reasonable interpretation, I do remember reading something from Gahan where he said something to the effect of, you know, Martin Gore wrote this in a sort of ironic way, or maybe, I think he said sarcastic, not ironic, but he was saying, like, Gore wrote it in a very sarcastic English manner. So I don't know, like, let me know if you think some of the lyrics are more ironic than genuine, but like I said, when I took it, I just took it to be that sort of treatise, if you will, that many punk bands and bands in other musical spheres have made, which is that ordinary people are more often than not the victims of sort of psychotic leaders and large political, religious, and cultural forces which often forget the humanity of the very people they mean to compel. So that's where I took it. But like I said, there is this suggestion that maybe the lyrics are a bit sarcastic. Nevertheless, here we go. I did want to show, you know, maybe it's construction time again. I guess we'll have to see. But I do love the imagery on this album. I love their sort of, you know, I don't know, like, they're almost like dissidents coming in to stir up the revolution, which I suppose, you know, I haven't seen the video in a while. There is a music video for this. As I said, I react to physical media, so full respect to people reacting to other YouTube videos. I just happen to do it a different way here, walking a different side of the street. But I do think, back on the video, and I think maybe there's a suggestion that they are sort of like leading this movement. They are trying to spearhead the revolution. So the imagery fits with that. Nevertheless, here we go. This is Where's the Revolution by Depeche Mode on their album Spirit from 2017. Thank you. love that high, pingy sort of melody. It's sort of covered by these like harder, larger, sweeping sounds, but that melodic line right in the middle of it all cleans out. Love that bass, man. Or just never given any credence at all. There's so many synth layers, it's like, I don't want to talk over too much of the song, but... Where's the revolution? There's a, like, rising metallic one there. And there's like a gritty electricity sort of like coating the track. You can hear it in the low end maybe more than anything else. It's always, you know, going back to the very beginning of Depeche Mode, and then obviously right up to about 37, you know, years later. Their ability to interject a musical interlude that sort of expands or changes the atmosphere. It's amazing. And again, they're trying to spearhead the movement. Get on this train. So again, maybe there's a hint of, you know, sarcasm or irony. Be curious to hear what people think. Chorus is so good. It's those low, gritty electric sounds in combination with that pingy, like very persistent melody. It's such a good contrast. There's that like rising one. Again, there's so much going on, it's hard to comment on it all. I love this stripped down section. It's got grit, electricity. And acidic like sounds in that bass. Amazing. I really love that tune. And it, when I heard it, I'll admit, it had been a few years since I had really kind of like... Because my I listen to so many different kinds of music. Techno, punk rock, hip-hop, reggae. In recent times, Iron Maiden, classical music. So what ends up happening is that I'll go kind of like in weekly phases. There'll be a couple weeks where I'm listening to a lot of one thing, and then I'll kind of switch for the next couple weeks and listen to something else. And what happens is I sort of move around to the different genres I listen to, and I don't get burned out on anything in particular because I just don't like cane it to death because I have other things I can listen to. So it ends up like I never get tired of anything because there's always more things to kind of keep my interest moving around. But I will say, when this album came out, it had been a hot minute since I had paid attention to Depeche Mode. It had been a couple years since I had really, like, I'm gonna listen to, you know, some old school synth pop and so on. But when I heard they came out with this album, I, you know, kind of rushed to the internet, and I remember hearing this song and just being like, oh my god. And now, at the time, I was finishing grad school, money was very, very tight, so I had even slowed down on buying techno records, and that's something that, like, you know, if you want to mix a lot of techno, you just kind of keep up with new records, you gotta buy old records. But it got to the point where I was, you know, so tight on cash that I wasn't even really buying techno. So the reality is I didn't buy this. But I knew of it, and that song, like, hit me harder than any other tunes on the album.
So, you know, in recent times I've been doing a little bit better. So, you know, I've been trying to expand some aspects of my musical collection. And it occurred to me when I started doing these Depeche Mode reactions, like, wait a minute, there's a glaring oversight here. I need to finally get that album. So I've done that. And I really do enjoy that song. And when I first heard it, like I said, I took it more in the vein of, like, sincere or genuine, in the sense that it's like, hey, you know, the downtrodden, the marginalized, the exploited, the neglected and ignored, this is a song for you. And it's saying, like, hey, you know, carpe diem, in a sense, like, find common cause, like, work together to create positive change in a way that will, like, push these old guard, you know, exploitative and psychopathic leaders, whether they be political, religious, or cultural, or social, like, out of those positions. So as I said, I then later read a thing by Gahan where he was basically suggesting, you know, there might be a hint of sarcasm to the lyrics. So I'd be curious to hear if people know more about that. You know, that's the only bit that I heard. I don't remember ever reading anything by Gore, you know, elaborating further on what he might have been talking about, but I would be curious to hear what people think. But as I always say, you know, lyrics are a dialogue between artist and listener, and ultimately, you know, the way that the lyrics hit me in that moment, even if I later come to understand them in a different way, that moment was sort of special for me. So, you know, like, to me, again, that's part of what this song means, even if in its initial, like, articulation, it may have had a different or indeed, like, sarcastic or ironic meaning. Anyway, let me know if you have any opinions on that. I really do appreciate the people watching these Depeche Mode reactions. As I mentioned, I was already doing some of them, but then once Andy Fletcher passed away, it just felt like we need to be talking about Depeche Mode tunes and albums and so on, and I wanted to jump around and do some more albums because I had done some from, like, the same three or four in the last few reactions. So I did want to get to this one, and now that it finally arrived, I'm very happy. So anyway, let me know what you think. I really do appreciate you watching. Have a good day. Have a good night. I'll see you next time. Peace.